Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I would like to show you the current development progress of Quantum Vitas. Since the release last week, there have already been 400 downloads, and I have received many comments and suggestions. Thank you everyone for that. The most wanted feature was actually phonon. Now I have implemented phonon calculation in Quantum Vitas, including the gamma point calculation and dielectric constant and Raman calculation. Then it's the phonon density of state calculation, as well as the phonon dispersion calculation. So in this video, I would like to show you briefly that Quantum Vitas could do that calculation. So we run Quantum Vitas. And then I have already constructed the calculation. Just let you see, this is the lattice for silicon. We can plot it in a conventional cell, and you are familiar with that. And then first, this is the calculation of the phonon at gamma point. And then for the gamma point phonon calculation, you could calculate the dielectric constant and also the Raman. We could turn on the dielectric constant calculation, and this is the result. I will not do here because it is a little bit time consuming. And you see that it calculates the phonon frequency at the gamma point, where you see three acoustic branches and three optical branches. Yeah, and in principle, this acoustic branch should be zero at gamma point, but here we didn't apply acoustic sum rule, so that's why it is not exactly zero due to numerical inaccuracy. And then you see that here, this is the dielectric tensor as well as the effective charges. Yeah, okay. And then this is the second calculation. Everything else is the same except that we choose Q grid here. And then we calculate the phonon in a 4x4x4 grid. And then select the density of state calculation on a denser grid. And this is the result. Yeah. So the red orange curve is the density of state, is the total density of state. And the green curves are the partial density of state on the projections. And then this is the third calculation. We first converge the phonon on a uniform grid, and then we calculate the dispersion of the phonons based on this list of k points. Yeah, and then this is the result, where you can see that this is the phonon dispersion of a silicon crystal. Yeah, so basically this is more or less ready. There are some other details that I plan to implement, but I expect that I could offer the next release, including the phonon calculation, next week. So stay tuned. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time.